Do I always get excited? No, I cry a lot sometimes. It's really hard and maybe I get a little depressed, but I always know that I will get through it. Okay, because the Lord says he will never leave me and he will never forsake me. Hey guys, welcome to this channel. I'm Sarah and Caitlin is not here with me. We make videos regarding specific struggles, specific topics. We love to answer them in non-fluffy ways, and so this video is going to be one of those not fluffy topics. The reason Caitlin's not with me is because we got a comment on a YouTube video that I made by myself regarding why I got off of Instagram, and this lovely girl named, I'm going to do my best to pronounce it, Gosia D. Marie, she commented and she left such a real comment with a real question, a real struggle. And so today I felt it on my heart to answer that very real topic of kind of not knowing how to be a good Christian in the sense of please God, his will, making decisions, hoping that it's pleasing him. Fear can so easily creep in, make you confused, anxious, and all these things. And so that's really what this video is going to be about. Please do subscribe if you feel like this is a channel in which you can get answers from, you can find peace and hope and joy from. This video is for people who are scared of making decisions, kind of like in fear that you're not going to please God, kind of in fear of like, is it the right decision that I'm making? You want to do the right thing. You want to live a life pleasing to God. You want to make sure that your Father loves you and that you're making the right decisions. And to be honest, the comment that Gosia left regarding like fear of really making any decision, that's something that I think this whole last year was something that I discovered and I felt myself and I conquered it because a few little tips that I'm going to give you throughout this video. So I just wanna read some things that she wrote. She's scared of making any decision in fear of not prioritizing God. It's harder for her to even decide like what t-shirt to pick, or possibly, I don't know, maybe there's a graphic on the t-shirt that she's scared will represent something wrongly, or that it's hard to even do homework. And honestly, I feel you. This is kind of weird, but there was a time when it was hard for me to even do homework because I was like, I'm not spending time with God. And so what's this all even for? So I feel you on that. We're gonna talk about that. And then another one that I also felt as well was like a struggle with planning the future, thinking about the future, dreaming, making goals to and reaching those goals, because you feel like, well, if God's in control, if he already knows what my life's going to look like, who am I to make a goal? Who am I to plan something? Let me just kind of accept what comes. So obviously what we can see here is that you're not free, because freedom really looks like you knowing that you have the mind of Christ when you accept it, that you are free when you have accepted Christ and now you're free to make decisions. You're free to use the wisdom that God has given you through the Holy Spirit to make decisions for your life. It seems like when we enter into struggles like this where fear has taken root because of our good heart, fear has taken advantage of our good heart that wants to please God, we become anxious, we become super confused. Because we're good people who want to do good things to please our really good Father, but then why is anxiety and fear in the mix? I actually read this book before Gosia commented this. It's called Do It Afraid by Joyce Myers. Obviously, this is not sponsored anything. We have like 562 subscribers. It is all about fear. And I cannot believe how many of us think that because sometimes we feel fear, maybe that's a sign that we shouldn't step into something, or it's a sign that something's not for us. The Lord did not give us a spirit of fear, but a spirit of self-control, love, and something else. And I'm saying that verse off the handle. And so if the Lord did not give us a spirit of fear, then it's already a lie that the devil has gotten a foothold of to tell you that if you feel fear, maybe you're doing something wrong. If you feel fear, maybe it's God trying to tell you something. God does not speak to us through fear, which leads to anxiety and confusion. That's not how our God operates. Our God is good. Our God wants good things for us, for his glory and for our strength. What happens is, as believers, from our past, for example, with Gosia, she played around with those law of attraction, and so she did her best to focus on the things that she wanted and hoping that her focus, her whatever, would attract these things. And so now, because of that past, it's leading her to be fearful of really like wanting to make any plan or wanting to make any choice in fear that it will not please God. All of us have a past. All of us have thought patterns in our minds that now are like strongholds, and they literally fight against the knowledge of God. Because if we know that God is good, if we know that He is a good Father, He is a steadfast lover, He is patient, He is good, He is peace, He is peace. If we know these things, well, we can see that our confusion, our anxiety, our fear that's paralyzing us from our decisions, that has nothing to do with who God is. And so we kind of want to discover, what thought patterns are we allowing to run rampant in our mind that are literally fighting and warring against who God really is and what He says about us? I want to quickly give you two tips if you don't go throughout the rest of the video. One, I used to think I had to talk to God a lot, like vent and talk to Him all the time to be like, to have a really good relationship with Him, until just recently I realized that reading God's word, reading the Bible, that is already communicating with God, because that is His word. That's what He says, and it's living. If you're in a place where you kind of don't even know how to communicate with God, if you have a past that makes you feel like you're not worthy of going to God, which is a lie, we're all not worthy, but we've already been redeemed. You have to choose to not let the lie that we're not doing good enough, the lie that we've sinned like every single night this week, let's say, we have to choose to wake up in the morning and literally crush that lie, because it is a lie. None of us deserve God's grace, His mercy, but we have been redeemed because Jesus Christ died on the cross. Reading His word is enough for now. Reading His word is enough. You don't have to prove yourself to God. You don't have to do works for God to love you, because He loved you before you were even born. Read His word. And the second thing is pray. For the people who get confused about like God's will is already established and stuff, God gave us control when He created us. He gave us free will. Free will means you can literally decide to do what you want to do. So what prayer really is you inviting God into your sphere, your circle of control. God can't make you do anything you don't want to do. Are there stories in the Bible when God made, let's say, Pharaoh do something? Yes, so God can do anything. But God doesn't make us do things we don't want to do aside from His own supernatural will. He can't, because He gave us control, or else we'd be robots doing whatever He wanted. So prayer is actually releasing control and saying, God, I don't know how my aunt's going to be healed, but I want to give You this. Please heal her. God, I don't know if I'm going to pass this class. I know that in my own, I'm nothing. But when I lift up things to You, the impossible can be possible. And so here, I'm gonna pray about this, and I'm not gonna fear about it anymore. I'm not gonna worry. My biggest piece of advice is, one, read your Bible. Read 1st and 2nd Thessalonians. Read what Jesus says in Luke, in Matthew. Be freed by His word, okay? Anything other than His word, question it. But the Bible, you don't have to question it. Read it. And then pray. Pray that God will reveal why you're fearful, why you have such anxiety about not pleasing Him. God will show you what's going on. God will show you if there's something from your past that is literally keeping you captive from moving into your future. He'll reveal it to you through people, through the Bible. Watch a YouTube video all of a sudden that pops up on your feed and it gives you the answer you're looking for. God will reveal it to you, because the Lord answers prayers. Pray about getting out of this trial and about learning what it is that's going on through this trial, because ultimately through trials, through mountains, is how we grow. That is how you leave stronger than when you came in. So the fact that you're battling with, let's say, like confusion and all these things, it's not from God, but God can turn any of those trials into something for your good. Let's get a little excited here that if you're struggling right now, well, you're going to get out of this struggle. And you're going to get out of it stronger than when you got in. You're going to leave wiser. You're going to leave stronger with more character. And also something that's cool is you will meet other people who are struggling with what you struggled with. And now you're going to be able to give them pieces of wisdom that God gave to you. So get excited, because I get excited when I go through trials. Do I always get excited? No, I cry a lot sometimes. It's really hard and maybe I get a little depressed, but I always know that I will get through it. okay? Because the Lord says he will never leave me and he will never forsake me. Though my feelings might not always be there, my emotions might not always feel the best, and they kind of take a back seat because I know that I know that I know God will never leave me and he will never forsake me. And the same is for you. He will never leave you and he will never forsake you. It doesn't matter how screwed up you are, how confused you are, how anxious you are. He has never left you and he will never love you more than he loves you in this very moment. Because God is love. Once you realize that, you can realize you're free. You're free to make decisions. You're free to realize that it's not by works, not by works that you're loved or you're chosen or you're called, but by God's grace. I know the struggle of making decisions, and I know the struggle of like, oh, should I do homework? Should I hang out with friends? Or should I just stay home and read my Bible? I have the freedom to decide. God has given me it, and he'll never love me more regardless of a decision that I make. And if I make a mistake, if I make a wrong decision, he can even redeem the outcome of that bad decision. And fear, confusion, and anxiety will get you nowhere. And that's something I had to tell myself. It will get you nowhere. What will get you somewhere? God's love, because it sets us free. Confusion, anxiety, fear only keeps us trapped. And it keeps us feeling shame, and it keeps us feeling guilty. Now, when I put it like that, do you want to live that kind of way? Or do you want to accept the gift that Jesus has given us? Love, forgiveness, peace, joy. What do you want to choose? The devil has tricked you for a little bit. He's tricked you into thinking that this whole guilt stuff, this whole anxiety stuff, that maybe that's God. It's not. Love is God. And with love, of course there comes discipline. Of course there comes some conviction. But conviction and discipline of the Lord always leads to a behavioral change that leads to more freedom, okay? If I have been sleeping around, now I'm convicted. I feel in my spirit like I did something that I wasn't created for. I'm convicted. That conviction, if I want and I choose, will lead to a behavioral change. God, I didn't like what I just did. It made me feel dirty, and this is not what you created me for. Well, the next day, my behavioral changes. Okay, just to make this story short, I'm not going to sleep around anymore, right? By the grace of God, he's gonna help me. If I'm tempted, if I make a mistake, he'll forgive me, but I wanna make that change. That change is going to lead to so much more freedom. Fear is just not with God. Conviction, discipline, yes, but it always leads to more freedom, always leads to more peace, always leads to more love. If it's leading to guilt, shame, regret, it's not of God. And I think that's gonna help you a lot, like a lot, because some people get confused, like, what if I'm getting punished? What if God's trying to teach me a lesson? What if this? Listen, he's a good God. The only lessons he's going to want to teach you is for your good, his glory. And your good looks like peace, looks like joy. He's not going to teach you through guilt and shame, because that's not how our God operates. That's how the devil operates. This is something I read in the book that I would quickly want to share with you. Jesus said, when the seed of God's word is sown in our hearts, distractions and the cares of this world will come try to steal the seed. Satan is afraid you will grow spiritually if we stay focused and let the word of God take root in our hearts, so the devil will try to find endless ways to distract us from Jesus and his word. That's what Joyce Meyer said, and before that was Mark 4:14-19. Satan is afraid you will grow spiritually, because if you grow spiritually, you're going to change so many lives around you. Your life's gonna be changed and everyone's gonna go to heaven. If you don't grow spiritually, and if you actually listen to the lies and the distractions of the world and of Satan, guess what? You struggle, your life sucks, you stay down, and so does everybody's lives who you were created to change, inspire, and give the truth to. Honestly, when I say it like that, like, it really makes sense. Thank God I prayed and he's revealed these things to me, and he's revealing it to you as well. Dale Carnegie said this, fear doesn't exist anywhere but in the mind. So realize that what you're feeling, what you're struggling with, it's only in your mind. It's not in the reality around you, and it's not in the reality of God's word. Fear is only in the mind, which is why the devil loves to use fear to affect our behaviors and our life. Because if he gets in the mind, and if he gets a foothold of one of your thoughts from your past,
then you might very well stay trapped for years, years, and years. I'm here to tell you that when Jesus died on that cross, we don't have to wait years. We don't have to suffer for years. Suffering can stop right now. And if I sin in 5 minutes, it can stop 5 minutes from now because I repent. And we can repent all throughout the day if that's what you have to do. Clear your mind, put off the old self, put on the new self that has received the forgiveness, the grace of God. When you accept Jesus into your life, you are now free and you also have the mind of Christ. Not every decision we have to go to God for in the sense of like, God this, God that. Sometimes God just wants us to take leaps of faith, and use the mind of Christ that he's given us to make decisions. So if you believe the lie that God has to say yes or no to every decision that you have to make, that's a lie, because God has given us the spirit of wisdom, the Holy Spirit, to help us make decisions. As we mature in Christ, we can grow, learn his word, and start making decisions as adults, as children of God. I hope you guys really enjoyed this video. I hope it made sense to you. If you want me to dive deeper into anything that I said, please just comment it down below. Please do subscribe and like this video. And like I said, comment down below if you have any topics you'd like us to talk about. Kaylin says hi. She loves you guys so much. And so do I. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye. Oh, yeah.